Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with today's edition of Stock Market Time and Television for Monday, July 23rd, 2012. In the pre-market this morning, we've got stock index futures down sharply. Dow futures are currently down about 200 points, so we are looking for some aggressive selling at the open on Monday morning. Now, there's certainly a lot of noise out there, but really nothing new to talk about. When we look at the weekly charts, you'll hear that bonds are higher this morning around the world, and bond yields are lower. No news there. You'll hear that the euro is weaker this morning and the U.S. dollar is higher. No news there. You'll hear that stock market indexes are falling. The global Dow is still on a weekly sell signal. No news there. Chinese markets were down about 5% this morning. No news there. Italy and Spain are both sharply lower today. Really no news there either. So far, nothing really new to talk about. The S&P 500 has been on a buy signal for the last few weeks, and the reason for that is the strength in U.S. bank stocks. That may have ended last week. We went from a bullish reversal bar, which put in the low, and we started to follow the market higher, and then we've got a new bearish reversal signal. Now, through that whole period, as the market was rising, the pros really didn't get too excited about this. In fact, they actually gave up control on this sector, so not a lot of enthusiasm there, not a lot of confidence by the pros as they used this rally as a selling opportunity. So here we are, we're coming into Monday, we're seeing a sell-off. The NASDAQ 100 has not been able to generate a weekly buy signal, and neither has the TSX. And of course, gold stocks spent their whole week trading below the lower channel line last week, so no change there. Looking at daily charts, we're on a daily buy signal for the S&P 500. That would change with a daily close below 1347.57 on Monday. Looking at the NASDAQ 100, we're on a daily buy signal. That would change with a daily close below 2578.14 on Monday. For the TSX, we're on a daily buy signal. That would change with a daily close on Monday below 11517. Now, the TSX might be a bit askew today. We've got Nexen seeing a takeover offer. The stock is going to be sharply higher out of the gate this morning. And, of course, it's part of the TSX 60 and part of the TSX Energy complex. And so that stock shooting higher may actually give us some weird numbers for the TSX, where the majority of stocks will probably fall at the open as this stock rallies. Take a look at commodity prices. No changes on Friday. Inside day for crude oil. No change for gasoline. No change for heating oil. No change for natural gas. On Friday, we saw copper come down to the lower channel line. A close below 342 would give us a sell signal on Monday. Gold is still on a sell signal, and silver is still on a sell signal, and both of those were lower last time I checked in the pre-market on Monday. And a quick look at the grains. No change on Friday. Corn continued to move higher. Soybeans continued to move higher. And wheat continued to move higher on Friday. Last update, a quick look at a couple of 60-minute charts. I was looking for a move up to 1375 for the S&P 500. We were able to take that out, not able to make the next price target, and then we started to reverse. We're coming off the top of the panic zone, certainly projecting lower prices. So even without the futures down 200 points this morning, we would have come into Monday looking for lower prices. Currently on an intraday sell signal, an hourly close above 1370.46 on Monday would give us an intraday buy signal. It was a weaker picture on the move up for the TSX and a weaker picture on the way down. We need an hourly close above 11,628 on Monday to give us a new intraday buy signal. And I really don't know how this index is going to look this morning with Nexen having the big pop and the rest of the market heading lower. We'll have to wait and see how that works out. But I'm not expecting to see a new intraday buy signal on Monday for the TSX. Okay, that's all for Monday morning, folks. Looking for sharply lower prices at the open. Of course, we care a lot more about how the market closes than how it opens. And we'll have to see if Monday's open is an overreaction to the news out of Europe, or if actually the pros want to keep it this lower or lower at the end of the day. So have a great day, folks, and I'll talk to you next on Tuesday morning.